Girls and boys, welcome to Unit 4, Practice and Review. This is probably going to be our last video for Unit 4 of Fundations, so hopefully you are getting close to completing the packet of worksheets. So, what we have learned? Well, we spent a lot of time, most of the time, on suffixes. And remember, these are letters or groups of letters which can be added to the end of a base word. And we learned five of them. Okay, so each suffix changes the meaning. That's important. If we add an S to a word like cat, and we get cats, it means now we're talking about more than one. If we add ES to a word, to a noun, like box, we get boxes, which also means more than one box. So these help us make plurals. They help us make something that is more than one. They also help us do something else. We can say, I saw four cats, that's more than one. But also, John walks to school. So the S tells us what someone else does. We can make a plural like she has five boxes, but we can also do this. Jen always washes her hands. Okay? So these suffixes do two things. They can make something plural, and they can tell us what he or she does, what some other person does, or what it does. Okay, and we had the ED ending. We can take a word like cook and make cooked, like mom cooked for 2 hours. Now, ED can do other things, but that's the only thing we're worried about right now. We also added the ing ending, so we can take a word like cry and make crying. I think I hear the baby crying. And for now, let's just say that tells us what someone is doing now. There are lots of other uses of ing, so many, but that's all we need to worry about right now. Okay, we also learned the very important ER. So we can take a word like listen and make listener. A listener is a person who listens. A teacher is a person who teaches. A reader is a person who reads. So ER tells us what someone does. Donna is a good student because she is a good listener. Okay? This is a little tricky because IR and UR also make the ER sound. Okay, but when we're talking about someone who does something, usually it's ER. Okay, ER is also used, and I'll give you the word. Remember that really big word that I used for this? When we want to compare things to make what's called a comparative, like faster. And EST can take the same base word and talk about it being number one, fastest, faster, fastest. A train is faster than a bus. That's a comparative. Two things are being compared. An airplane is the fastest way to travel. That means that there are many ways, but the airplane is number one. That's called a superlative. Okay, EST, cold, colder, coldest, big, bigger, biggest, tall, taller, tallest. You get the idea. And remember, what's tricky about EST is that it sounds like it's IST. Okay, but we don't want to spell it that way. We want to be sure that we use the E. Also, remember, these are not always suffixes. For example, we can say today I rest, yesterday I rested. That's a suffix. But EST that you see here is not a suffix. It's actually part of the base word. Okay, so just because EST is at the end doesn't mean it's a suffix. Look at the right side. When we have the word singing, ing, the second ing is a base word. But is a suffix. But here, ing is part of the base word. So look at that. You've got ing and ing. This is part of the base word, so it's not a suffix. But this one is. That's a little confusing. And there are many words like this. Okay, let's move on. Okay, and we've also talked a little bit about marking. So if we take a word like this, picking, we're going to underline the CK because it's a digraph, underline the base word, which is pick, scoop the syllable, because remember, some base words could be many syllables, and then we put a brev over the I because it's picking, it's not piking. Okay, it's a short C, that makes it a closed syllable. And then we circle the suffix, okay, picking. Okay, this next part is really important. We have three ways of saying ED at the end of a word. We have packed, banged, and listed. Of course, we're going to circle our suffixes, okay? And then when we mark these words, we have to be sure that we mark them with the way they sound. Packed sounds like a T, so we'll put a little T above it. Banged, we can hear the D there, and that's what we put above it. And listed gets an ID because it actually sounds like id. Okay, so remember this, there are thousands of words that end in ED. Okay, and we also learned a lot of vowel teams or vowel digraphs, and we haven't learned how to mark these yet. So when we worked on long O, we saw OA, like boat and groan, which is not the groan that we use when we see our relatives and they say, "Oh, my Marcia, you have grown." No, this is groan like, every time I have to eat this, I groan. And we saw it in words like float and oatmeal. Remember, OA is never at the end of a syllable except in the word cocoa. We saw OE, another way of making the O sound, like in toe and flow. And remember, FLOE is when there's a lot of ice moving on the water, an ice flow. But unfortunately, OE doesn't always make the O sound, like in shoe and canoe. We don't say show and canoe. And these are always at the end of the syllable. We also talked about OW. OW can make a long O sound, like in blow and own and rainbow. But it can also be OW, like an OU, as in words like down and now and owl. Okay, so OW is a tricky one. Be careful. And we learned even more vowel teams. We learned the OU vowel team, which can be OW, like shout and trout. But it can also be OO, like group and soup. Oh, that's tricky. And we also learned the OO, which could be OO like in school, but it can also be uh, like in book. Oh boy. This one is also tricky. Be careful. All right, and we learned EW, and this was in words like chew. Okay, now fortunately, this one doesn't have a tricky partner like the other vowel teams that we saw. Ah, so we can even say words like, whew, what a relief. Whew, whew. Remember, we have not yet learned how to mark these vowel teams. All of these are going to come back, and we're going to learn how to mark them, and we're going to look at lots more words that have them. So this was just kind of an introduction. In Unit 4, we also learned these six trick words: sure, animal, use, again, please, and used. Okay, so let's practice these one last time. Your first word is sprinted. Sprinted means ran very fast. She sprinted to the supermarket. Okay, and here it is. And remember, when we do this, we're writing the word twice. The first time is the way we thought it was spelled. The second time is the way it actually is spelled. Okay, if it's wrong the first time, just leave it that way. It's okay. If it's right the first time, you still have to write it again. Okay, the next word is smaller. Smaller. Her bicycle is smaller than mine. Okay, here it is. The next one is cracking. Cracking. They were in front of the fireplace just cracking walnuts. Cracking. Remember, ask yourself what the base word is. Cracking. And here it is. Next is dresses. Dresses. She has so many dresses. Okay, and here it is. The next word is paths. Paths. I love to go to Birch Grove Park and walk through its many different paths. Okay, here it is. And the last one is foxes. Foxes. They say you should be very careful if you see foxes on your farm. Foxes. Okay, here it is. Okay, make sure you have everything written down. And you know, foxes, people say so many bad things about them, but they're actually not bad animals. They can actually be pretty cool. Wouldn't it be fun to hang around with this fox? I think so. Okay, boys and girls, that's the end of our Unit 4 review. We have a test coming up. Make sure you have all the worksheets finished, and have a fantastic day. The end.